Levels lets you change the brightness and contrast of images. You will find it in all image editing software and in Substance software like Substance Painter and Substance Designer. Levels is a very powerful and important tool, but you might have trouble understanding it at first. In this video, we'll explain Levels to you so you can make it a core part of your workflow. We'll explain all concepts related to Levels with grayscale examples that represent masks or height maps. You'll find these easier to understand. We will only use low dynamic range, which means our values are limited between 0 for black and 1 for white. If you want more information on this, we have an introduction video that goes into more detail. When you look at the Levels tool interface in any software, you can't miss the big bar graph. This is called the histogram. You get an overview of the values within your image. It lists how many pixels there are of each value between 0 and 1. If your image was completely black, the leftmost bar of the histogram would be at its maximum. If everything was white, the rightmost bar would be at its maximum. An image where every value is almost equally present, like a linear gradient, would have a nearly flat bar graph over the entire range. Usually, you will see histograms with a peak or slope shape. With some practice, you can learn to understand the value range of an image just by glancing at the histogram. This graph, for example, tells me there's a lot of dark values with only a few bright parts. This graph tells me all values are sitting around middle gray, so it's lacking a lot of contrast. This graph has a nice even spread between values and uses the full range from black to white. In many cases, this sort of histogram is what you should be aiming for. Now that you know how to read a histogram, you can start using it to understand levels. You probably know standard contrast and brightness settings with a slider for each. Levels perform similar operations, but with different, more precise controls. You can find these controls in two categories, the in and out level controls. In this video, in is shown at the top, out at the bottom. But you should keep in mind that in other programs, like Photoshop, they can be arranged differently. In controls let you expand the value range of your input by redefining the lowest black and highest white points. There are three in control handles: low, high, and mid. When setting the level in low control, you are readjusting the blackest area. When setting the level in high control, you're readjusting the brightest area. Level in mid controls the transition. For example, if your map is lacking in contrast, you can readjust your low and high controls to use the full range from black to white. This means levels in lets you increase contrast. A traditional contrast operation would just move the low and high controls closer together in the center. Levels in gives you more precise control, where you set exact low and high points for your contrast range. You'll find this useful when all values sit outside of that central range. Remapping your levels in to use the entire range from black to white is a very common operation. You make sure no data is lost or ignored, and you ensure maximum fidelity when blending it. You can always reduce it with an opacity slider later, but you can never add more contrast when blending. Auto Levels does this for you. It finds the lowest value in your image and sets the low value to that, then finds the brightest and sets the in-high value, expanding your range. Auto Levels doesn't look exactly the way you want often, so manual adjustments might still make more sense. The middle levels control, also called gamma, changes the transition between black and white. You'll understand it best when looking at a linear gradient and its cross section. Adjusting the mid makes your transition go brighter or darker quicker, but does not adjust the endpoints of the transition. Those endpoints are controlled by the low and high controls. You won't use level in mid as often as low and high. You will use it mostly when adjusting the slope of a height map or to slightly change a mask transition. As an extra note, because we are working with low dynamic range, levels in can only increase contrast. In HDR, where things are more complex, you could also decrease the range. Levels out does the opposite of in. It limits and shrinks the range of values. You'll find levels out easier to use as it only has two controls, level out low and level out high. They work like limits or clamps for your image. For example, If you reduce the level out high, the brightest part of your image can only ever become as bright as that out high value. So, level out high sets a maximum high limit. Out low does that for dark areas. It limits your blackest value, setting a minimum low limit. Moving high and low together thus creates reduced contrast. For example, if you have a mask with overbright areas, you can reduce the level out high to make the bright spots darker. The same applies to height maps, where level out can be used to set the absolute height of components. Levels out reduces contrast, and so does the opposite operation of levels in. In some cases, in and out levels can even cancel each other out. As a note, if you work in high dynamic range, levels out could also be used to expand the range. Let's recap and compare to standard brightness contrast adjustments. Levels in lets you increase contrast by moving handles closer together. Brightness is changed by moving both low and high handles left and right. Levels out lets you decrease contrast by moving handles closer together. Brightness is also changed by moving handles left and right. A side ability of levels is that you can invert an entire image with it. Both in and out levels let you swap the positions of the low and high controls. As soon as they cross each other, the image inverts. Usually, this is done with the level out controls. While the histogram and level control handles give you a visual, easy way to adjust things, it is not an accurate, precise way to work. All level controls also allow you to type in precise decimal values. In some cases, this can be useful to precisely limit an image to an exact value. Keep in mind, different programs might use different values, even though the principles stay the same. One very common operation with procedural masks is to use a soft, sloping image as a source for a levels that lets you then grow or shrink that mask. This way, you control the placement and range of something like dirt or grimes. It involves bringing the level in high and low close together to create contrast, and then moving them together between left and right to shrink and grow the mask. You can only move one control at a time, so this is slow to do with the control handles. Substance software like Painter and Designer provide an additional effect called Histogram Scan, just for this purpose. It is a levels operation with remapped controls, letting you adjust contrast with one slider, and grow and shrink that range with a second slider. It's a great tool that is used as much or more than the standard levels. You'll find a few other histogram operations in Substance software. All of them are remapped versions of levels for achieving certain effects faster. Histogram Shift is in both Designer and Painter. It lets you move or shift the entire range, achieving a sort of scrolling effect. You can see it literally slides your entire histogram. Histogram Shifts lets you easily re-randomize a grayscale map like cells 4, for example. In Designer, you will find two extra histogram operations, Histogram Select and Histogram Range. Histogram Range works like a scan, but on levels out. That means it reduces contrast and changes brightness. It works best on height maps, where you can use it as a scale and offset tool. It squashes your height map and moves it up or down the range. Histogram Select allows you to select a specific point on your sloping, soft masks and then fade out in two directions from there. You'll find it useful for masks extracted from height maps, where you can select a specific range of the height map quickly. For example, you could select all the lowest areas to add dirt and grime, or to add a water level, or you could select high areas to add wear and tear. So, to recap that, histogram operations are slight variations of a levels with remapped controls. While you have a lot of control with standard levels, it might be slow or cumbersome in some cases. You might be better off with a histogram operation.